In the spotlight this morning, a new supernatural horror film is hitting theaters tomorrow. The Conjuring is about paranormal investigators Ed and Lorraine Warren, who work to help a family terrorized by a dark presence in their farmhouse, forced to confront a powerful entity. The Warrens find themselves caught in the most terrifying case of their lives.
In 1971, the Perron family moved into their dream home.
It's gonna be great.
But they didn't know it was the site of a brutal murder in 1863 and countless horrors in the century that followed. What happened to the parents in that house was so disturbing, the family has refused to speak of it. Until now.
That's right, until now, and here this morning to tell us more about the story and the Rhode Island inspired film is Andrea Perron, author of House of Darkness, House of Light. Good morning.
Good morning.
We don't have too long, but I could talk to you for about 5 hours and listen and hang on every word. This is, first, tell me about the book. You moved into this house in Harrisville, Rhode Island when you were 11 years old, right?
Well, they bought it. My mom and dad bought it when I was 11. We moved in after Christmas in 1971, the first week of January, so I had already turned 12, and my youngest sister was 5.
When did the paranormal activity begin?
The day we moved into the house, we were unloading boxes from the truck. It was a swirling ice storm outside. I walked through the dining room and politely greeted a man, a full body apparition that I saw standing behind the door. And I just said good morning and kept walking. And then my sister came in right behind me and she said, Mom, who's that man in the dining room? And my mother said, what man? Mr. Kenyon's packing the last of his belongings. She said, no, the man behind the door. And my mother said, honey, there's no other man in the dining room. And then Nancy came in right behind, right, little peanut that she is, and she leaned over to Cindy and she said, you know that man in the dining room? He just disappeared.
Wow.
And so, that was it.
So give everybody at home a little background about what happened in that house before you moved in, and then a little bit about what happened while you were there.
Well, the house was completed as it is now in 1736, and 8 generations of one extended family lived in that house and died in that house, and at least a dozen of them never left.
Really? Now, and let everybody know what the owner of the house told your father as you were moving in.
As we were getting ready to take him to his new home, mm-hmm. he said, Roger, come for a walk with me, and just laid his hand on his arm and said, for the sake of your family, leave the lights on at night.
Okay, all right, now I'm really creeped out. the spirits that were in the house, one of them was called Bathsheba, right?
Yes.
Okay, now, supposedly she hated your mother, mm-hmm. but lusted after your father.
Yes, she was overt about her attention to my father, and she coveted us, the 5 children. Bathsheba lost all 3 of her children before the age of 4. So if it is indeed Bathsheba, and there is still some question about that, because Mrs. John Arnold hung herself in the barn, and she obviously broke her neck, and the apparition that would repeatedly manifest in the house had a broken neck. But so there's always going to be that lingering question, the mystery of it truly, mm-hmm. is who was it that was haunting that house? But the fact of the matter is that whatever it was that was after my mother still to this moment perceives herself to be the mistress of the house, and she didn't appreciate my mother's competition for that role.
And do you believe that that spirit is still in that house?
No question about it. I took my dad back there for the first time after 30 years last summer, and we weren't in the house 5 minutes, and
yeah. Okay. All right. Why? When did they come to you about the movie?
4 years ago. Mm-hmm. That was the biggest leap of faith. Signing my name to a contract blind.
Right.
Hoping to God that it was going into responsible hands and turning the rights to our names and likenesses over to perfect strangers who turned out to be the most perfect friends.
Really?
Warner Brothers Studios and New Line Cinema treated very difficult subject matter with the utmost respect and decency and maturity and intelligence. I could not be more pleased.
You're not going to believe what just happened. As you touched me, everything around me just went dead. And I'm not kidding. I can't hear anything anymore.
I do that. I don't mean to. Uh-huh. I just suck the life out of everything that's got a battery in it. My mother says I'm the ghost.
It's unbelievable.
I don't even know how much time we have because, like I said, everything just dropped out.
Sorry.
As you touched me, everything went out. Just quickly, you had a book signing. Tell us about the book signing quickly.
Last night, we went to the Jesse M. Smith Memorial Library, our beautiful little library in Harrisville, right. Rhode Island, which is now apparently the center of the universe. And people had been lining up since 3 in the afternoon and stood in line for 5 hours. To meet me and sign it. I was overwhelmed all the way to Cello's in Smithfield.
Wow.
I cried after we left. I just cried and Dad's like, it's okay, honey, it's all right. I said, Dad, you don't know how emotional this is. 2 days ago, I was walking a red carpet in Hollywood with the stars of this
right.
film, and I was completely cool as a cucumber.
And now you're
I come
nervous.
Home to Harrisville and I lose it.
Oh, man. Well, thank you so much for coming in. Great to have you here. I could talk to you for about 5 more hours. If you want to read Andrea's book, House of Darkness, House of Light, her 3 books. We'll post more information to WPRI.com, and you can check out The Conjuring in theaters this weekend.